Engineer by virtue of what I studied in school. So I studied petroleum engineering in the University of Ibadan. That's my BSc I did. You know, my name is Chidi. I'm from Anambra State. I'm married. I have three lovely kids as well. You know, but I didn't start my journey with trader, right? I started a company in 2014. So at the paper cup factory, what we were basically focused on at that time was doing branded paper cups and actually selling it to people that want to do weddings, events, coffee shops, juice bars, and all of that. So that's where I started, you know. So, and I got that inspiration in China while I traveled. I traveled to China with my dad to do some car shopping. He's into cars. You know, so on that trip, I saw paper cups in a couple of companies that we visited. So, and that actually struck me that this is something that is not very common in Nigeria. You know, that's why, you know, one needs to be very aware of your environment. To be honest, all the business I've started, you know, came yes. as a result of the stress of your environment, you know. So that's where I picked up the idea of the paper cup. I came to Nigeria, came back, did a bit of a research about it, then started the company called the Paper Cup Factory, you know, which is an extension of a UK-based company at the time where we had like an extension of their brand here in Nigeria. So we started, we brought in some cups, we learned how to do branded cups, you know, we started, it was not easy because at that time, people really are not really exposed to paper cups. Paper cups was not really very common in Nigeria at the time, you know. So because of that, I had to start a coffee shop as well because, you know, you need to show people how to use the product. Yes. If you have a product that people don't know how to use it, they've not seen it before, you know, that means they're solving, you know, and that strategy really worked because as people come to the coffee shop, they use the cups and they say, oh, I can use this for my event, I can use this for my program and all, you know, so that's how we started selling cups and, you know, so funny enough, so the customers that are buying cups from us, it now happens that they needed other forms of packaging as well. They needed bags, they needed boxes, they needed other forms of food packaging. So that's how we grew our SKU from just offering cups to offering other forms of food packaging as well, like paper cups, bags, donut boxes, pizza boxes, and all of that. So we became a full-fledged packaging company in 2017, you know, and in 2018, we moved our operations to Lagos because we started in Port Harcourt at the time. Moved to Lagos in that same year, we launched our e-commerce platform where we sell packaging online, you know, and trust me, that would be the first e-commerce platform that is focused on that's where I started going into tech a little bit because, you know, though the site started as being a Shopify product, I used a Shopify tool, which I built the app myself, loaded the product, put in the pricing, did everything. Shopify is pretty easy to use, so that was not really a big deal, you know. So that was where I got into, but yeah, I would say I'm mature tech.
It's thumbs up.
Yeah, thank you. And what actually motivated us to do that was, you know, we went to a couple of exhibitions, right, in Lagos, and we discovered that a lot of food businesses really want to buy this packaging, but they don't want to focus on buying branded items. I'm a kind of person, I know, you know, God has given me the gift to be able to spot opportunities and actually act on them, you know, and to be creative and innovative, you know. So when we noticed that a lot of people are asking, this packaging is nice. At that time, trust me, people do branded bags, branded everything. You want to do bags, everything was branded. You have to do 500 or 1,000 pieces. And I said, I spoke to my partner and said, these guys want to use this bag, but the only challenge is that they can't afford to do 1,000 pieces, right? Why can't we do 100 pieces if we don't need to print on them? Then they can print a sticker and put on it, and that will become, you know. We now created a new arm that's now do plain packaging, you know, which was not in existence in 2016-17. So we started doing, so if you want to buy bags, we can give you 100. If you want to buy boxes, we can give you 100. But is not printed. So, and since we are selling these low quantities, it just makes sense to have an online site where people can just go and place order for it. Because now you're buying things 7,000, 12,000, 15,000. It's not breaking the bank anymore. And you can use the eco-friendly packaging for your solution.
I can see, it seems you don't longer work there, right, at the moment.
Yeah, I founded the business. So because of what I'm doing with Trader, you know, I just had to take a back seat on that to focus on Trader, you know, because, you know, there is power in focus, right? I can't basically push two companies at the same time. Trader is something that's going to be a new concept, and it's going to be very, very big. And we see that it's something that's going to change the way trade is being done in Africa presently.
I'll briefly talk about you being a director at Kojo Motors. I think that was the automobile company you were talking about.
I'm a non-executive director there, so I really don't work day-to-day there.
What's Trader?
Okay. Trader is a platform that helps buyers to shop from any physical major market without actually going there, you know? So let me just quickly paint a scenario for someone to understand, right? Let's say I'm in Lekki right now. I live in Lekki. So, and I'm able to buy something from Alaba Market. I'm able to buy some spare parts for my car from Ladiko Market without actually going there. I'm going to do that from the comfort of my phone in my house. You understand? And I'm going to get those items delivered to me. You know, so it's different from me going to buy something in Jumia or Konga or any of these platforms.
How is it possible? You know?
Yeah.
We know that a lot of people in the market are not technologically inclined. Not exactly. All of them. I'm not saying they are not, but, you know, people are not yet welcoming the idea of fully trading online. So is there a scope in the market? Is there a specific set of people you are looking at? Is there a partnership?
Everyone in the market, with that woman that is selling crayfish on the roadside, from that man that is just selling some spare parts that is holding, from that guy that have shops along the street, they are all welcome to be on the platform. And how are we tackling this? You know, at the moment, Nigeria has been rated as a country that has over 33% unemployed youths, you know, looking for job. And these guys they can read and write. Most of them have smartphones, but they really don't have anything to do. They don't have a job. You understand? So what we are trying to do, or what we are doing, no, not trying, we're already in it. What we are doing is creating a platform where we can leverage on these people to actually shop for people that are not in the right position to go to the market. So when you look at it, and the approach a lot of businesses have tried to use that really was not successful is that, you know, you are right, 80% or even 90% of the people in that market are not educated. But we have educated people, we have people that have a basic knowledge that we can leverage on those people's expertise, you know, their technical know-how to reach those people that are not educated. That's basically what we are doing. So we are not connecting the buyer directly to the merchant, but we are connecting the buyers directly to a shop. Shopper is someone that has a smartphone. He can send a text message. He can use WhatsApp. He can make a call. He can communicate to someone in any language, basically. So we're going to link that person to the shopper that is in the market or that is around that market. You put a list of what you want to buy. That shopper becomes your personal assistant at that time. He goes to the market and help you achieve what you want to do. Then we are going to be in the picture. We are not just putting you in the hands of that person to start and conclude the transaction. So we are going to be in that market. You are buying in Ladiko Market, for example. We are going to have our presence in Ladiko Market. So whatever that guy is doing, he's going to come back to us. We are going to inspect it and package and dispatch your products to you wherever you live.
Okay, yeah. So now every market you have a representative, someone
you
call a shopper.
Yes, we have a shopper. Yeah, every market we onboard, we are going to be onboarding by God's grace, thousands of shoppers.
Okay, not just on one, that, thousands of shoppers.
Yeah, thousands of shoppers. Our goal is
this,
to have...
This is a very interesting part because I believe the high unemployment rate is something we can tackle with technology. I've always been saying this. Creating opportunities is really what can work for us in Africa. Yeah. Because
basically,
if we are trying to wait for the system to work for us, then we are lacking behind. We have to correct the system ourselves.
Yeah. So
creating opportunities for people to be a shopper and get paid for shopping for people is really a very nice idea. But you know, the question people ask now is, I don't trust the shopper. I trust trader. I don't trust the shopper. Is trader the one recruiting the shopper directly?
Yeah.
Or there's another model you are using to get these guys?
No, we are recruiting the shopper directly. We have our own vetting system that has actually gone through a reputable HR company, you know, for us to recruit these shoppers, and they are working for us. And mind you, and we're going to put a very strong disclaimer here, if you want to, because you have a line of communication with the shopper, you know, Nigerians being who they are, some people might want to bypass trader and say, okay, I'm talking with this guy. Oh boy, give me your number now. Make you send that to me.
Make I follow our talk.
Yes, we can't be held responsible or liable for such transactions. What we are assuring our customers and our users are, we are in the picture. We recruited this shopper and they are answerable to us. So whatever they are buying for you is, we're going to have a collection hub where those items are going to be, they'll bring it to our shop. You are not paying to the shopper, but you are paying to us. When you pay to us, we are going to be your first line inspector in the market to verify what the shopper has done. We'll verify what the shopper has done. We'll receive your money. If we need to call you for clarification and reconfirmation of some items, we do that before we send those items to you. So if you are dealing with us and coming through the proper way, you can never be scammed. You can never be defrauded, you know. But if you decide to go the back door, you can't hold up. Bible, you know, and we're also going to be putting a lot of structures to educate the shoppers as well, to tell them this is a platform that we have created to be of benefit to you. There is no point trying to corner a customer behind. If you are working with us on the platform, we'll have a rating system. You're going to be rated, you know, your scores are going to be coming high, and we have we're structuring a lot of benefits where we can actually have shoppers grow on the system and start making good money for themselves. You know, our goal is to be able to make sure that every shopper earn a minimum of 10,000 naira every day. Wow. If you're earning 10,000 naira every day, in 5 days, that's 50,000, right? In a month, you can be sure of getting to 100K, 200,000 every month, at least, even if it's not up to, but at least you have more... 3 or 4 times the minimum wage in Nigeria. And basically, that is going to be super explosive.
You talked about trust.
Yeah.
And one of the major problems we have in Nigeria is trust. People find it very hard to trust. And a little mistake can, you know, damage a brand. So I'm looking at how does the model work? Is it that... you communicate to a known shopper, you've seen the name, you've seen the number where you can boycott the system, or is an encrypted system where you can just only make a conversation like you are chatting with Tradera and the person is a representative of Tradera and you don't even know the person behind the view. You know, that means you can't really boycott the process. I guess you understand what I'm saying.
Exactly.
So I want to understand, is it a one-on-one conversation model or a model whereby you can't boycott it through encryption?
Yeah, let me explain basically how it's going to work, because the MVP is almost out. We are doing testing as we speak. And, you know, sometime this month or next month, it's going to basically be in the market, you know. So it's really important that people get to understand how it works, right? You know, on the platform, we have an in-app system, in-chat system on the platform. You know, So you come to the platform, we are connecting you to a shopper. You know, we have a 5C, you know, for trader, we have a 5C system. You know, the first system is that you choose a market. You choose a market where you want to go based on the market that we have onboarded on the system. So let me take Alaba Market, for example. You choose Alaba Market, you write a brief list of what you want to buy. It could be you want to buy a TV, you want to buy an AC, you want to buy a sound system or whatever. You put that list. Once you put that list, the next step is that we'll connect you to a shopper. And when we connect you to a shopper, you start chatting. You know how many millions of transactions that happen on Instagram DM. The people don't talk on the phone, just on DM. I run a packaging company, so I know that people will go to the website where they can buy something online. They will copy the phone number from there and now start doing WhatsApp. Do you understand?
Yes, you get. That's how we do now. You want that personal feeling.
Exactly. People want that personal feeling. And that is what I believe that our system is going to achieve, you know, that is peculiar from the regular e-commerce platforms, right? So we connect you to a shopper where you can have that personal interaction. The shopper can advise you. All these things happen within the chat communication. He sent you the picture of what you want to buy. He puts the price, you know, and the way we built our system is that it's going to be live picture. The shopper can't send a picture that is saved in their phone, whereby they are sending you pictures of what is not available. That cannot happen. So when you are sending a picture on the app, you are only sending real life pictures of what you use. You open the picture, the camera button, you are snapping a picture in the market and you are sending, and you are putting the price right there. You know, and the buyer can bargain. You guys can negotiate and everything. You can price it just like you're in the market. You know, you can do your negotiation. If you are comfortable with what the shopper has sent to you and you want to make that purchase, you just click accept on the chat. When you click accept, it moves that item to your cart. Just like you're shopping online, it moves it to your cart. You are done. You end your conversation. You go and make payment for that item. Once you make payment for that item, it triggers the shopper to bring that item to our collecting center. So it brings the item to our collecting center. We inspect it. We look at what the pictures you have, what the list you want to buy, what you requested. Somebody checked your conversation to make sure that what he brought is actually what you ordered, and we send it to you. So for now, on the MVP stage, there is no opportunity to have an in-call conversation. All you need to do is to chat. And our goal is create a system that the shoppers will love to use. Create a system that is exact, that the buyers are comfortable to use. Why do people want to game a system in the first place? Maybe they are not comfortable with one thing. They feel the price is too high. They feel the service. You know, so we're going to build a system that is a community we are building. So everybody is helping each other to grow. We are trying our best to make sure that our system can cover all your needs such that you actually prefer to be on the system than actually be behind it. Yeah.
Wow, this is massive. For me, I think the summary of Tradera is, you know, trying to create the normal traditional way of shopping in a digitalized form. I think that's a summary, and that's a very
totally
that's a very wonderful idea. Would Tradera be raising any fund, or is it going to any VCs, any micro VC? Or
Definitely. For a project like this, this is massive, you know, this is massive. So there is no way we can achieve to do this at the scale that we want to do it without raising funds. You know, imagine at your house now, you are buying your food and vegetables from a market in the north directly. The name of the business is Tradera Africa Limited. So it's not just in Nigeria. With all the trade, inter-country trade that's coming up, we're going to leverage on all of that as well. You understand? The international market is one of the biggest markets in the whole West Africa. You know, and how many people can actually access that market? How many people can actually access it from Lagos, from Kano, from Maiduguri? You know, so this is huge. So to answer your question, we can't do this without raising capital. We're going to raise capital and we're going to use it effectively and create one of the biggest, e-commerce platforms in Africa.
The launching of the products, is it determined by the capital, or you are still launching without the capital and with the hope of raising capital later? Or you raised the capital already?
No, we've not raised. We're talking with a couple of investors now, you know, but that's not preventing our launch. We're going to launch anyways, you know, and discussions are still going. You know, some investors are also looking at us. Okay, let's launch this product and see if people are going to use it.
You know, the concern with startup founders, a lot of startup founders is, how do I raise fund? Where do I get the funding? Are they raising in Nigeria? Who want to invest in the market? Nobody is even assured that the government policy will not come tomorrow and say, what you are doing is not right. So are you raising in Africa? Let me say in Africa, because Nigeria is in Africa. Or you are looking beyond the African soil to actually invest in your company?
Trust me, a startup like us, what we need is funding, right? To be honest, 80% of the startups don't really care where the fund is coming from. We just need fund. Because we have what we want to build. You know, we are seeing the vision, you know, but we need the catalyst to take us there. So I won't see a foreign fund and say, no, I'm waiting for a Nigerian funds, right? No, you know. So if you look at most startups that are doing very well, most of them are striving on foreign funds. You know, it's very painful because, you know, the country is blessed with a lot of people, a lot of opportunities, money and all that, you know. But at times, people don't just, I would like to say they don't believe, or they don't just want to help startups. You know, it's really very sad where, you know, foreign venture capitals at least will come to Africa and invest in the big businesses, you know, because one, they are able to see the future. They are able to connect well with the founder and help them achieve what they want to achieve. You know, it's more like we are losing out, because for them to invest in your business, you know, 100% of the time they want you to register that company somewhere else, and it becomes a foreign brand, so to say, even though it's operating here in Nigeria. So our system, they really, people need to wake up. I will commend some companies already that are waking up to that challenge, some African venture capitalists, right, that are actually looking at the African ecosystem and, you know, trying to raise funds and support some startups.
How do you combine your work with your lovely family and you try to balance the whole work and family stuff? A lot of techies have issues with that, and we love you to share that.
Yeah, you know, I don't even consider myself a techie. I'm not a programmer, right? I'm just... But, you know, but yeah, to answer your question, you know, it's just to create that time for it, you know, and what we have learned after the COVID period is that a lot can actually be done from home. You know, you really don't need to go to the office every day. You know, at times I work from home. At times I work two days at home, 3 days in the office. You know, weekends I'm always at home working from home as well. So, you know, everyone should just find a way to create that balance, because it's not going to be nice that you're spending all the time with your work and at the same time your family is not having good quality time with you. So, you know, everyone should create that balance. I'm not there yet, but I'm trying.
When are you going to start recruiting for the shoppers? It's something we would love to know. And I'll probably also amplify the news when that's starting.
We have started already. We have over 50 to 100 shoppers in Lagos Island Market already, waiting for us to launch the app, because we, you know, this is an operational business. It's not just a tech, like a payment system where you're not dealing with human beings, right? This, we are dealing with humans. There's going to be serious operations to make sure that things are moving. You know, we've got over 50 shoppers already in my 12th market. We've gotten over close to 100 in mind. So we've started, you know, we've gotten the first set of shoppers that we are launching with, but this is going to be a continuous process. But as we continue to grow, you know, we can definitely be in touch. If you also have a community of people, you know, the thing is, I want to also deal with people around the market communities that we're working with, you know, because we don't want a situation where somebody is living in Lekki and he wants to work in the market in Alaba market.
You have a great plans for the Nigerian youth, the African youth. You have a great plan for the ecosystem already. And it's something I must commend. It's something we have to commend. It's something we appreciate in the community. We all want to see startup grow. We all want to see these companies grow. We all want to see everyone achieve the whole success. You know, it's something we are clamoring for. It's something we want to see. The ecosystem is let me say, this is a fintech company. So I'll still put it on fintech. Yeah. You know, me, I'm more interested in other tech. You know, fintech is everywhere, but I'll still have to commend it. This is a steady process. It's something people will adopt. It's something people want. Nobody wants to leave the house to go and go to any market again. So when there is shoppers that are interested in making money, we can create opportunity from that.
Only aspect of growth is when you grow with people, you know. So I commend what you are doing. I commend what your team is putting together as well. You know, it's super powerful. Well done.
Yeah. Hi.
I mean, yeah. I.